political leader of the closest and most important ally Australia has is embroiled in a massive corruption scandal. US President Joe Biden and his family are now facing calls to explain the millions of dollars from foreign nationals that's found its way into their bank accounts. We've seen revealing text messages where a Biden family member is demanding payments from Chinese Communist Party operatives and whistleblowers, and it reveals a network of payments for policy all under the stewardship of the Biden family. And apparently Joe Biden was in the room. These make a mockery of Biden's claims to never have discussed business with his perverted crackhead son, Hunter. Have a look at this.
Does this not undermine the president's claim during the 2020 campaign and the reaffirmations of that claim by his two press secretaries since then, that he never once discussed his son's overseas business dealings with him?
No, and I'm not going to comment further on this.
While few in the media, and even fewer in the White House, want to take this seriously, it is notable that the US House of Representatives voted this week to send articles of impeachment against Biden to the appropriate committee. I bet you didn't hear about that in Australian media. Now, we know that the impeachment process can and has been previously used solely for political purposes, but the evidence against Joe Biden and his family and the cover-up of that evidence by the FBI and the Department of Justice, it simply cannot be ignored, and yet it largely is. You might be asking yourself, why is this important to us? Well, America is our largest and strongest ally. We rely on them for our national defence, and their status on the world stage actually matters to us. So instead of the world media highlighting the true crisis that's engulfing America's politics right now and its legal institutions and its first family, we've actually been consumed with fodder of a failed submarine and a contrived and failed 24-hour coup in Russia. Don't get me wrong, both of these are notable events, but they're hardly more newsworthy than the crookedness and corruption that's evident in the politics of the land of the free. There is something truly rotten going on in the world, and unfortunately, it's not what we're being directed to look at or to consume our lives with. When the establishment say, look over there, it's usually because there's something they desperately don't want you to see much closer to home.
It has, by any estimation, been an extraordinary last 24 hours in Russia, watched with bated breath around the world. It seemed at one point that the Putin regime stood on the brink, with a column of military vehicles heading to Moscow. The leader of the rebels, Yevgeny Prigozhin of the mercenary group Wagner, has now done a deal to leave for Belarus. The rebellion began early yesterday morning in Rostov-on-Don, when forces of the Wagner group occupied the headquarters for Russia's military operations in Ukraine. They then seized control of military facilities in Voronezh, about 500 kilometres south of Moscow. A mercenary convoy then advanced north of Voronezh along the M4 motorway towards Moscow. Russian forces then erected defensive positions and blockaded main roads and bridges along the route before the order was given for the mercenaries to stand down. Well, let's get the very latest now from our Moscow correspondent, Diana Magne, who is live in the Russian capital. Good morning, Diana. What is the mood in Moscow and what is the military situation as you understand it?
Well, I mean, it's a sunny morning in Moscow, and I think people yesterday were watching events with a degree of confusion. And I think in Moscow especially, now they have a day off tomorrow, so they're probably just enjoying this peaceful resolution. And I think, though, there will be a lot of people who are questioning what on earth actually happened. And given the shadow it sort of casts over Putin's authority, over his credibility, you know, bear in mind the fact that early yesterday morning he went on television and made a big speech talking about how this was treasonous, a stab in the heart of the Russian people, essentially, and only a few hours backtracked and let Prigozhin slink off to Belarus, where he is either en route or already in situ. It doesn't look very good for Vladimir Putin. I think there are a lot of questions being asked as to why on earth, Prigozhin, who is entirely a man...
Please join the conversation. Put your comments and suggestions below in the comment section. Thank you for subscribing to this news channel. You will be notified of any breaking news and new post as you become part and parcel of the MACAD TV family. Please like and share MACAD TV. We love you all. Please support MACAD TV Foundation by joining membership and visiting Amazon UK to purchase the displayed books to aid our orphanage projects across Africa.